Hey folks, welcome to Quantsap and welcome back to yet another video. Are you an option trader and do you want to learn to handle theta in a systematic way? Then this video is for you. In this video, I'll be sharing you 5 hacks to handle theta. So the idea is very simple that first I will start this video from the very scratch, wherein even if someone has started options trading just now, even he can make the most out of this particular video. So we will learn first what is theta. Then I will share you 5 hacks, which will involve strategies and which will involve, you know, evolving our strategies depending on how the market conditions are. So let's start this today's video by understanding what is theta. So we all know that options, they are wasting asset. That means you can't go ahead and buy options, and you can't go ahead and make an investment in options. You can't go ahead and buy and sit forever. That option will give you money in some point in time of life. But options, for each and every passing day, you hold that option premium. Okay, some premium would be deducted from that option premium because of time. So that exactly is what theta is. What is theta? Theta is decay in option premium because of passage of time. In the entire world, even if everything remains the same, how much premium would be decayed because of passage of time is shown to you by theta. So let me just show you how it will happen. So Nifty futures price is 18,150, expiry 5th of January, strike price 18,150. Self-explanatory thing that I want to calculate option premium for 18,150 strike price option if the Nifty's futures price is 18,150. Then the tool will ask me for what date you want to evaluate the option premium. So I'm saying I want to evaluate the option premium for 30th of December with volatility being 10%. You can give whatever inputs you want, but I'm keeping it simple, 10% volatility. Now, if you see, it is showing us that my call would be, if these are the scenarios, my call option premium would be around 93 rupees and my put option premium would be around 92 rupees. So roughly around 93 rupees is my call and put option premium. Now here comes the enemy of the option buyer, which is theta. What is theta? It is showing you that if you hold this option for one day, which is from 30th of December, if you hold it till 31st of December, 7 rupees would be deducted from the call side and 7 rupees would be deducted from the put side. So 93 minus 7 is somewhere, or 7.7 to be precise, is somewhere our option premium would be quoting. So let's try to do this. Let's go ahead and evaluate the option premium as on 31st of December 2022. See, my call option went down by 7.7 rupees. My put option also went down by 7.7 rupees. Now the thing is, theta, so let's make a note of it, by the way, before we move ahead. Okay, so what is theta? Theta is nothing. Time decay in option premium if held for one day. Okay, that is theta for us. Now, the thing to learn over here is that market is closed now. It is 4:57 today. Market is closed now. Tomorrow is a Saturday. Okay, 31st. I am recording this video on 30th of December. So tomorrow would be 31st. So happy new year to all of you. But the idea is that tomorrow is 31st and a Saturday, and day after is 1st Jan, which is Sunday. We can go ahead and trade in options. But the thing is that theta will decay. Theta will take its option premium even on Saturdays and Sundays. So it is like, let's say you bought, you rented an apartment, right? But it doesn't matter for how many days you stay there, right? Even if, let's say, you rented an apartment for a month, and even if you stay there for, let's say, for 3 weeks, still the owner, he will charge you the rent for the entire month, right? So that is the entire concept over here. So the theta will work even when the market is closed. So even on Friday and Saturday, even when the market is closed, be it a bank holiday, be it anything, even if the market is closed, the theta will decay, the theta will keep on killing the premium, right? But what will happen is you won't see that the theta will decay on Sunday and Saturday. You won't see that happening in the option chain or something. It will open with a decay on Monday. Okay, so most of the theta, it will get decayed on Friday in the later half, and on the Monday opening, okay, it will open with a decay. Okay, so that is the entire concept. So now what is the actionable, right? What is the actionable? Now let's say I am bullish on Nifty. I bought a call option, let's say at 12 p.m. and nothing happened in the market. Okay. Now, if the market would have opened tomorrow itself, which is fine, I am paying theta for just a night. But now the market, it is going to open directly on Monday. So I am paying theta for Friday, which is Friday night, Saturday night, and even Sunday night. So I am paying unnecessary theta even when the market is closed. So the actionable is that if you are buying, okay, so let's say if you are buying options, so what you need to do is Friday, so this is our first tag, by the way. Friday is your actionable day, which means that you either go ahead and exit your position, that means whatever profit or loss it is, you just take it and you can recreate the trade on Monday. If you have a bullish view, again, when the market opens on Monday, let's say at whatever level it is, if you have a bullish view, you go ahead and again create a trade on Monday, which will save you eventually from maybe 15, 20 or even more 30 rupees of theta decay possible. Okay. So let me just show you. So let's say theta architect. So I'm creating a custom strategy. Okay. Nifty 18, let's say ATM is the option I am buying, right? So if you see this line, it is showing us the price of Nifty right now. So what does this mean? That if market remains exactly where it is right now, today EOD, it will give me no profit, no loss. But if I held this option for 3 days, okay, 3 days, which is Saturday, Sunday and Monday, I want to evaluate the option premium as on Monday, end of the day. If you see and market remains at the same level, I will make a loss of how much? 1400 rupees, roughly 1462 rupees, roughly around 1500 rupees is what I will make a loss if market remains exactly where it is right now. So what I can do is, first thing is I can go ahead and exit this trade and recreate the trade on Monday. That is the first thing. Second thing would be convert the strategy into a spread. Okay. What type of spread it would be? Simple. For a directional forecast, it would be a bull call spread or a bear put spread. How to do it? I will tell you. It is simple and I have shown you in a lot of videos. What you need to do is just go ahead and sell a higher strike price call option. But before that, let me just show you. Greeks, if you see 433 rupees is what the theta that you are paying. But if you just click on add leg and let's say you are going ahead and selling of 18,400 strike price call option. Okay. So now if you just focus on theta, it is 150 rupees, right? So you did something. So, and if market remains exactly where it is right now, you made the loss, you cut it down the loss, you know, half. Why? Because you have a sell leg now, which is protecting you from theta decay, right? So, and again, if it moves upwards, you will start making profits. So that is the case. And it will save you from the potential theta decay. Now, let's say this was simple because, you know, we had a directional forecast. But what if I don't know, okay, I don't know where the market is going to go, but I have created a long volatility strategy, okay? So, I have created a straddle. So, all of you might be knowing how a payoff of straddle looks like. If you don't know, I'll just show you quickly. So let's say this is the strike price, what I have bought call and put options. But again, the problem in this strategy is I am long on both the options. That means the theta will decay from call and put both. So if I hold this option strategy for 3 days from here, 2,900, roughly 3,000 rupees is what I am losing only because of theta. Because why I'm explaining this is, you thought that the market will move in any direction. This strategy tells you that if it goes anywhere, you will end up making money. But the thing is, you expected that. It is not that 100% of the time it might happen. There might be a chance wherein market might remain in this vicinity, which might give you a loss. So in this type of scenarios, you can hedge this strategy as well. Okay, you can go ahead and hedge this strategy as well. I'll just give you inputs how you can do it. So let's say Nifty. So you bought these call options, add the money call and put options. So net delta is neutral because you are buying one call and you are buying one put. So you have a non-directional strategy, but the delta is neutral, but the theta is negative in the strategy. It is killing you like anything. So what you can do is you can go ahead and sell call options, okay, call and put options of, you know, 20, 25 delta, okay, 20 to 25 delta. Ekdam precisely nahi karna hai, but 20-25 delta is something what you can sell. So these options will cover you from the theta decay. At the same time, the probability of these options turning in the money would be less, right? These options will move, but they will move very, very slow. So that is the case. So what we will typically sell is, we will sell, let's say 17,900. Okay, we will go ahead and sell 17,900. And we will go ahead and sell 18,400, right? This is our option strategy, what we will create. Okay, 18,400. So let's go ahead and analyze this now in Architect. So all you need to do is, before creating a trade, go ahead and do this analysis. It would be fruitful. Or else you can do this, you know, even on Friday, bazaar band hote hote. Like somewhere around 2-2:30 something, what, let's say, you can go ahead and keep this strategy. Okay, what I mean is, you can keep this strategy, long straddle as it is. And at Friday around 2-2:30, only if you don't want to exit. Exit karna hai, that is completely different story altogether. But if you don't want to exit, Friday around 2-2:30, what you can do is, you can go ahead and sell deltas. Okay, you can go ahead and 0.25 delta ka call and put option, you can sell. So I'm selling this. And another strike price I'm selling is 18,400. Okay, call. See where I was making. So let's say if I hold this for 3 days. Okay, so where I was making a loss of how much? 3,000. I am making a loss of 1,200. Right? With again that forecast of market going anywhere. It is still open. I will make less, which is okay. But I am not losing a big chunk to theta. So the another type of strategy is 0.25 or 0.2 delta, right? Depending on, you know, what is your trading style, what gives you the best reward to risk, 0.25, 0.2 delta option, sell hedges for long vol trade. Okay, if you want to do it, that is the case. Now coming to the another aspect, that theta, one of the most favorite strategies of, you know, option traders is such that they will go ahead and sell call and put options both. But you know, if you are having an oscillating and a kind of forecast wherein the markets might not move a lot, so one type of strategy, especially when the IVs are relatively at a lower level, what you will practice is, you will practice something like an calendar spread. Okay, why calendar spread? Because if you see, so this is IV chart of Nifty of last 250 days. So orange line is showing you IV. So if you see, the black, the red line is showing you the lowest level and the green line is showing you the highest level of IV. So if you see that they are relatively at the lower level. Lower IVs, lower premium. Chance of IVs going up from the lower extreme. So if you sell call and put both, and if the IVs go up, you will again, that might create a dent for your option strategy. And the last thing would be, that if you have an oscillating view in such type of market, then, you know, going ahead and simply selling call and put option might not be lucrative. The reason being, if the IVs go up, that creates a problem. Second thing, the premiums are not enough to give you that cover, and still you are exposed to an undefined loss. So what is the strategy that you can deploy is, you know, you can go ahead and analyze something like a calendar spread. So I have covered, made an entire video on calendar spread. So you can go ahead and analyze those type of strategies as well. So sell. So if you see, your short position will have a negative vega. That means if the IVs go up, the strategy will give us a loss. Okay. But if I convert the strategy into a calendar, which is, I have an oscillating forecast, and even if the IVs go up, still I want to make money from the market. So if I add it, and this is how it will look like. First thing, no undefined loss, right? Second thing, it is vega positive strategy, right? IV badhne ka paisa milega. Third thing, it is theta negative strategy. So that means the more you hold this strategy, the more better it is. So it is oscillating strategy with a positional view, right? So let's say even if the IVs go up, let's say by 50, or let's keep it realistic, let's say 28%. See, now your strategy has started to give you more profits. So another way of handling theta in low IV conditions, okay? Okay, is such that calendar spread, something like calendar spread, is something what you can try to observe. Okay. Or else, not, if not this, if the IVs are low, iron fly, that means you will go ahead and sell call and put options of at the money, and you will buy the hedges. Okay. That is something what you can do. In high IV conditions, what you can do is you can go ahead and do a strangle. Okay, if the IVs are high, so now you will get out of the money pe bhi zyada premium. Now the IVs are low, so the range is narrower because the premiums are very small. But if the IVs are high, what you can do is you can go ahead and sell, you know, strangles, and you can buy hedges. So strangle, but you need to buy hedges. So you can convert the strategy into iron condor and you can protect it. So this is how, you know, you can go ahead and tackle theta in a tactical way, in a much more efficient way, and, you know, in one of the most simplest ways. Yes, folks, that was it from my side. Thank you so much for joining me up till here. If you have liked the video, do hit the like button, do hit the subscribe button. So whenever we post any video, you will be the first one to receive the notification. Bye-bye. Take care. Happy trading.